Hey there, Bob Deeks with RDC Fine Homes. I am back at our net zero renovation here in beautiful Whistler, British Columbia. Pretty exciting day for us here today at this groundbreaking project where we're going to take an older Whistler home, renovate it, and convert it to net zero, meaning that it can produce as much energy as it uses once we're finished. We are 2 or 3 days away from drywall, and today we've got Airtight Solutions here that is going to install the Aero Barrier air tightness system. We'll go on inside and have a look at the prep work that's underway. This is an atomized sealant that gets installed under pressure within the house. It'll find all the gaps in our exterior building envelope and make sure that we get down to our 1.5 air changes to meet the air tightness requirements for our net zero label with the CHBA net zero labeling program. So let's go on inside and see how the guys are making out with their prep work. So the guys are finishing up here, prepping the window. You can see that blue film on the bottom of the window track. That's just to make sure that none of the aero barrier sealant collects on the bottom of the window track. And all the green tape there is to seal the opening doors to make sure we don't get sealant where we don't need it. You can see they've taped the track up on top there as well. Just protect the door to make sure we don't get sealant where we don't want it. And then you can see up in the corner here, what's really important is any large gaps that we see in the framing, we want to make sure those are sealed. So they've done a little spray foam. There was a big gap there. And then you can see they've just caulked this long vertical seam in the framing. One place that we know is a little bit susceptible to air leakage are these long linear gaps. So we're just going to go around and pre-seal those before we start our spray. You can note the back of rod and then the caulking, the white caulking that you can see here that gives us a really nice airtight seal between our doors and our windows. We only seal our doors and windows to the inside. We leave the cavity to the outside open just to make sure that if there's any moisture that gets in, it can always get out. So there we go. Prep well underway here. You can see they're starting to spread out the hoses, set up the spray guns inside. They're a couple hours still away from starting their spray. We'll be back this afternoon to watch the spray in progress. Of course, our target here is to get down under 1.5 air changes. That may not mean much to everyone, but that's just an indication of how tight the building is. You can see the guys in the background just laying down some plastic to protect the floor so it's not a sticky mess after we finish spraying here.